we're gonna see the invisible. We're gonna see where that column of hot air is coming up off the candle.
Dr. Jim Bales studies light rays and how they can affect an image.
The boundary between the warm and the cold air, light rays get bent a little bit.
But his study of light at the MIT Edgerton Center goes far beyond candles and heat to the world of slow motion photography and catching moments the naked eye will never see.
A typical video camera will give you 30, maybe 60 frames a second. And a high-speed video camera is happily giving you images at thousands or tens of thousands of frames a second. We like our instant replay in slow-mo, but similarly for the sports teams themselves, when they're doing work with their pitchers, it's actually helpful for them to be able to have the pitcher throw the ball and then go back and immediately see exactly what's going on. We recorded at 10,000 frames a second. We're going to play it back at 20 frames a second. So everything you're going to see here has been slowed down 500 times.
Watch carefully, because what appears to be one balloon is actually two.
Now the needle goes in, the balloon tears, peels back, and right here, we're about 4 thousandths of a second after the moment the needle went in. So the outer balloon's already gone, the inner balloon is still sitting there.
Right, right, still intact.
That's right, because you're not that fast. And now the needle goes into the second balloon and we see it tear vertically and the edges come peeling back again. And there it's gone. And if we look at that timestamp again, it's been about 4 thousandths of a second.
4 thousandths of a second, and you can see all of that happening.
When we do bullet work, we take photos of a bullet cutting through a playing card. Bullet cuts through the playing card and the top is just like hanging there.
Right, right.
Because it hasn't had enough time to really begin to fall yet.
To share their extensive knowledge of high-speed photography, the MIT Edgerton Center opens its doors once a year for a four-day hands-on experience.
And it's geared for just about everyone. And the goal is to give everyone that ramp up the learning curve so you will walk out of here knowing what you can and cannot do with the cameras, what they will allow you to see, what they won't allow you to see, and how to use lighting and lenses to best effect.
Wow.
That's cool.
I know it is. Now, the 2019 short course will be held next June. Uh-huh. Registration is open. You can learn more about it at the MIT website.
All right, so how much do these cameras cost?
Some of them are over $100,000.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, even the low-end one, like $4,000 to $5,000.
Right.
So you think your little smartphone's doing pretty good? Nothing to what these guys have on. Yeah, it's pretty amazing to see what they can do with those cameras.
That's amazing,
so, yeah, it is.